Hey folks, in this episode of Dev with Sirdar, we're going to take a look at Rich, a Python library for creating colorful and formatted text in the console. If you write a Python app that uses a command line interface, odds are you have something fairly unassuming looking. No colors, no formatting, nothing like what you'd expect to see in, for instance, a web page. But modern terminals support a lot of text enrichments, and with them you can make your application not just prettier, but more useful and readable. And Rich does all of this for you and more. So here in this demo, I've set up a Python virtual environment with Rich, and I can invoke a simple example like this and get a whole slew of different outputs to demonstrate what Rich can do. Now, to find out how we can do some of these things ourselves, let's take a look at some actual code. So if we just want to print colored or formatted output to the console, Rich gives you a couple of simple methods for doing this. One is to use a style system, where your print statements have an accompanying piece of style data. For example, if I want to print in red against a white background, I can use one of a number of ways of expressing that. All of these commands generate red text on white, and I can supply exact hex codes or RGB values, or just the text red on white to describe what I want. I should note that the pre-stored values for red on white here, they're a little different from my generated values, but the idea should be clear. And I can also use programmatically created text objects that render colored and formatted text. Another way I can use formatted output is with Rich's own print command, which I could use as a substitute for the regular one. So there, I could use inline markup, like the old BB code formatting from online message boards, to indicate how I want my text to look. So if I run this, you can see how each of these generates the same colored output, just with slightly different approaches based on what you might need. Another thing Rich can do is it can take text in Markdown format and render it to the terminal. So here we have a piece of text with common Markdown elements in it, including a URL. And when we render that to the terminal, we get a pretty good facsimile of what it looks like on a web page. You even get clickable links if your terminal supports it. Rich also gives you pretty printing utilities, ways to print Python objects to the console in a way that's easy to read. Here's an example demo. I just have to type py-m rich.pretty, and all of these objects, dictionaries, lists, tuples, named tuples, all the rest of it, they're a whole lot more palatable to read in the console using Rich than if we just used Python's native pretty print module. Now, if we want really sophisticated formatting, like columnar output, we have that too. Here, I am generating multiple lists of random numbers, which are then formatted into columns of automatic size. Now, we can also specify how many columns we want or how wide we want them, or otherwise manually format this output, but it's nice just to be able to throw this data at Rich and have it all sorted out for us. Another wonderful out-of-the-box feature in Rich is progress bars. All you need is some sequence object, which you can give to Rich to automatically display a progress bar, along with an auto-computed estimate time to completion. And you don't have to build any of this, it's done for you. Now you can get more granular control over the output if you want to, such as if you have a task that takes some indeterminate length of time, as is the case with this URL fetching operation. So if I run this example, we'll start with a countdown for our timed operation, and then when that's finished, we get a pulsing bar to indicate that we now have an operation with no determinate length. Now, most of what Rich will be able to give you is limited by what your console can support. For instance, most consoles can't display images inline, at least not in the way we would expect from a web browser, so Rich can't really support that. But the range of things that it can support makes it a powerful way to take a text-only app and enhance its presentation and its utility. And it gives you convenient ways to do all of this that would otherwise be painful or complicated to build from scratch. So that's it for this episode. If you liked it, leave a comment below. And don't forget to follow Dev with Sirdar and InfoWorld on Facebook, YouTube, and InfoWorld.com.